Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Vermont Catamounts and the Louisville Cardinals.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Cardinals are in for what should be an easy one tonight, Dick, but how do they stay interested enough to win this game?
Interested or not, Brad, they still have to do the following things. Number one, get the ball inside for the high percentage shot. That'll open up the outside game as well. Next, you gotta pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby. And lastly, play your game on defense. Let your defense dictate their offense.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. On the outside. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. And off the mark. It in. He's gonna muscle it on the inside. Got it. He gets the foul and the bucket.
That's how you do it when you want to win, baby.
He steps up to the line.
Nothing but nylon, NBN. Pressure that basketball.
They look to get it to the inside. Fakes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. There's a bad pass right to the defender.
Defensively, they keep limiting their chances.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two. They still don't score. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Gets the rejection. Trying to feed inside.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you've got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Way off target.
Up and inside. Trying to go inside. Double team now. Bad angle.
Now the high screen. And he missed. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Number four fakes the shot. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset for the bucket and in and out. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
The Catamounts have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
There's a double team waiting there.
Oh, what a strip, Red.
The center handles the pass. Good defensive stance there against this swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
foul. He got the dunk and the foul.
He went through that lane on a mission, Brad.
With the free one. And there they miss one. Strong rebound.
Good rebound position. Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Number 10 handles the feed. Got it. This is getting ugly.
Hey, if you can't check your man, it's up to the coach to recognize that and make an adjustment.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Number 14 with the tray. Takes the pass in the paint. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Power forward receives the pass. Look at the student section, Dick, cheering on their classmates, their peers. If you ask any coach or player, I'm sure they'll say that the student section is the best.
They look like they're having a blast.
On the inside. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
The small forward receives the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He tries a three ball. Sinks the shot.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Top of the circle, off the rim, and no good. He makes a nice shot fake. Goes up for two. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Trying to draw the foul.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Number one is emotionally fired up.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad. That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Gave it up. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Lost some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? On the dribble, gives it up. Number one is called for the foul. First personal foul. What a play. These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball, though?
Off target. On the outside. Got a wide open look. For two, Louisville are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad. A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
My goodness. Players these days in their athleticism basically jumping up in the air and then deciding what they're going to do. I'll tell you, it must be nice.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. He takes a three, goes in. Got the high pick. Perfectly executed. Moving it around the perimeter. They'll work it around the arc. From three-point range. Way off. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And off the mark. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Working it around the perimeter.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 10 steps to the line for the first time. He hits the first. And he got them both.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go two for one.
Gave it up.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
The low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
At the half, the Catamounts are down by four. Dick, what would you say is the play of the half in this tightly knit affair?
My ally, Brad, has to be the great work in the paint so far. It'll be interesting to see who keeps it up in the next half.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. Vermont is guilty of poor shooting in that first half, and I mean poor shooting, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, you're too nice a guy, I know that, but you're too kind. The Wolf was shooting, they're going through a wound with any ball games.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. He looks for the bomb. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
Entry pass in the paint. He's got a nice shot fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Both teams looking to get things going here. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He tries the three ball. The shot won't fall.
High post screen.
So effective, that screen.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Tries for two. They still don't score. Two with a lay-in. Number 10 picks up the foul. First personal foul. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
He does the sweet fake shot. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Rims out. The skip pass is picked off.
There's the screen up on top.
For two. There they come with a double team to stop it. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. They're working around the perimeter.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Let's it fly. Off the rim and no good. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He intercepts it. Almost lost the basketball. He unloads a three. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Gave it up. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Goes up for two. Lays it in. Looking for a good shot. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. He posterized him.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrew. Aaron?
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
Aaron's right about that.
I tell you, Aaron's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Free throw is good. The center with the ball. Time to pick up the defense here now. Good job defensively. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, as you can imagine, I am seeing a completely different attitude on the bench now than I did in the first half. The coaching staff and players, they just have looks of disbelief on their faces.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
They're working around the perimeter. Here's a double team. The ball goes out of bounds. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose here and you get balled like I am.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
Stolen.
Up and inside.
Kicks it out. The point guard takes the feed.
Nice high post screen. Good rebound. Great position on a rebound. Good block out.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Picked out of the air. The center gets the pass. For two. Off the rim and no good. And he'll kick it back outside. He up fakes. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. As you would say right here, Mr. Vitale, Flop City.
I tell you one thing, absolutely a flop. No doubt, Mr. Nessler.
Slaps the rock out of there. Basket falls despite the contact.
Spacing.
Great defense. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making the throw to lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Kicks it out. On the dribble, gives it up. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Goes up for two. And he missed. lobs it inside. Number three draws the personal. There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'd say the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
Misses the second shot. Cleans the glass.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Gave it up. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Dick, you said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, won this game rather than look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The State Farm drive of the game.
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
The Cardinals played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.